Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Here I am explaining you the video series about bubble sort. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with another solved example. I have already explained one example in the previous video session. Now in this current video session, let's start with another solved example for bubble sort. Before that, if you are not knowing the concept of bubble sort, let's take a overlook on that. So bubble sort is very simple method which is used for sorting the numbers in either order, that is either in ascending or in descending. Mainly it uses the technique of comparison. That's why it is called as comparison based algorithm. Usually it compares the adjacent elements or the pair, and after that, or after every comparison, the decision is to be taken. So after comparison, if the adjacent elements which are compared are not in a required order, then the exchange or the swapping of those two numbers are to be done in the bubble sort. And mainly the concept of exchange we are going to use over here, that's why this algorithm is called as exchange sort algorithm. Now let's see what is swapping, what is exchanging of the adjacent elements. So while comparing the every pair, whatever the adjacent elements are compared, after comparison, if the elements are not looking in a proper order, then we have to swap them, that is we have to exchange their positions. This concept in detail I am going to explain you when you will see the solved example. So in short, we will see how it works so that will be easy to all of you to solve the given problem statement, the given set of values in ascending order. So first step is, for all the pairs we have to compare the elements for all the pairs, and if that two elements within that pair are not in order, then we have to reorder them. While reordering them, we can take the help of swapping concept. This is called as the iteration, because the two elements in the array we are going to compare, and if required that we are going to swap, and after end of every iteration you can see that the largest element is located at the end of every pair. This was the step number one. In the step number two, what we'll do? In the step number two, we'll perform the task that we have done in step number one repeatedly till end of the array. And this is called as end of the pass, or whatever the steps, whatever the iterative steps we are going to perform in step number two is nothing but the pass. And at the end of every pass, the largest element of the array is located at the end of the array. And these two steps we have to perform repeatedly n times if the size of array is n. And the total number of passes required for this is nothing but n minus 1. And at the end, you will get the whole list in a sorted order, that is in ascending order, because specifically these steps are designed to sort the array in descending order. Just to perform the same task in descending order, you just have to check whether the comparison, after the comparison, if the pair is not in descending order, then you have to rearrange them by swapping. Now let's start with the unsorted array. If the five elements are there with us, they are not in a sorted array, they are not in a sorted order, then after applying a bubble sort, this is the pass number one, and let's start for the comparison. So a first pair, let's compare whether the swapping is required or not. Yes, the swapping is required, because we are performing the bubble sort to sort the elements into the ascending order. So let's swap the exchange their position, and now let's compare the next pair. Let's compare 11 and 16. No swapping is required. So that's why keep them as it is. Let's compare the next pair, 16 and 1. Yes, swapping is required, exchanging is required. So let's exchange the position of the numbers and your array will look like this. Let's go forward for the next pair. The next pair, 16 and 13. Yes, swapping is required. So let's swap the numbers or exchange their position and your array will look like this. And at the end, you can see that over here, the numbers are in a, after end of pass 1, the numbers are looking like the highest number, the largest number, heaviest number is settled down at the end of the array and all the numbers are bubbled up which are lighter in the weight. Let's start with the pass number 2. Let's consider the same array. Let's check the first pair, whether the swapping is required to sort them in ascending order. No. Let's move forward for the next comparison, next pair. Yes, the swapping is required as 11 is greater than 1. So let's perform a swapping, exchanging of the position of these two numbers. And after that, you can see over here, the 1 and 11 are swapped. Let's compare the next two numbers. They are 11 and 13. No swapping is required. And here you can see that the number 13 is settled down to the end of the array. Let's start with the pass 3. In pass 3, here you can see that previously two numbers are settled down and only the three numbers are remaining for the comparison. So the swapping is required as 7 is greater than 1. Let's exchange their position. Let's perform the swapping on these two numbers and your array will look like this. Next comparison will be between the next pair, 7 and 11. No swapping is required. So that's why 11 will settle down to the proper position. And this will the array at the end of pass 3. So the pass 4, n minus 1 passes are going to be required. This is the last pass because total 5 values were there in our array. So comparison is done. And no swapping is required, so that's why at the end of the at the end of this pass you will get all the numbers in a sorted array. So at the end, after applying a bubble sort, your sorted array is like this. So here we have done with the sorting. Thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the video and the content, please do not forget to give the comment and do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a subscription link. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for a next video of this video series. And the whole video series in the form of playlist, I am providing here for your reference. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning.